must be fine and having a great time at your home. So yes, students, today I am launching my first video of electrical engineering, and the subject that I am going to cover is switchgear and protection. नाम तो सुना ही होगा. सो ये बेसिकली जो सब्जेक्ट है वो बहुत ही रिगरस सब्जेक्ट ऐसा माना जाता है, ऐसे इंजीनियरिंग स्टूडेंट्स मानते हैं, लेकिन मुझे नहीं लगता कि ये कोई भी एंगल से इतना रिगरस है अगर हम इसकी स्टडी ध्यान से और समझ करके करें तो. राइट, लेट मी टेल यू दैट आई कंप्लीटेड माई डिप्लोमा इन 2016 एंड देन आई वेंट फॉर माई डिग्री. सो दिस सब्जेक्ट इट विल ट्रबल यू इन बोथ द फेजेस, इवन इफ यू आर डूइंग डिप्लोमा इंजीनियरिंग. In the final year, it is going to come in the sixth semester. And after doing diploma, if you are going for a degree engineering, there also this subject will come and trouble you. So, dear friends, let us make one clear understanding that why this subject is considered to be the most, you know, I can call it as a toughest subject. Just not because it have more logical reasoning, more logical concepts are there to be understood. But only students feel it difficult just because of lack of practice, just because lack of understanding. They are not able to understand that subject in that detail or in that better way. And that is the reason I feel, you know, students ko aisa bahut bar lagta hai ki ye switchgear and protection mein to ATKT aani hi aani hai ya fir backlog aani hi aani hai. So yes, dear students, no need to worry. I will help you out. I will start from the scratch and gradually, you know, step by step, we will learn different concepts. बहुत ही summarized और बहुत ही compact है ये subject मेरे हिसाब से. So this is not a today's session is not going to based on any topic, but yes, for sure, I will show you that what all topics that we are going to cover in the coming sessions. Okay, so just I will give you a mind map kind of thing so that it will become more easy for you to understand that what all things we are going to cover. So the first unit, I am not going to take this entire subject based on unit wise, because see, in diploma there are different units wherein the concepts are catered in a different units. In degree we have several number of units, right? But we will see as a whole, we will learn this chapter, we will study this chapter as a whole, as a concept wise, right? Okay, so let us start with the first part. Let me assign the name unit 1. So first, dear students, we are going to discuss in the first chapter, I would say first module, I would say, in there we are going to discuss about the various kind of protective schemes. Yeah, various kind of protective schemes. But before starting with the various kind of protective schemes, I will explain you what is the term switchgear all about, why there is a necessity, why there is a need of protection for a particular system. If we will not give the protection, then what will happen? So these all things we are going to study. So in this protective schemes also, friends, we are going to discuss about principles and need of protective schemes, nature and causes of faults, how many types of faults are there, if any specific faults occur at the overhead system or the overhead transmission line, then what are precautions we should take and what are precautions need to be taken before the fault arises, right? And types of faults, definitely we are going to discuss. Then we have current calculation, that is my IF calculation. What is the value, what is the amount, what is the exact value for my current, fault current, and how I need to eliminate that fault current from the system. Then also we have methods of neutral grounding, how we can ensure the neutral grounding and how we can we can be very much precise whenever there is a fault and whenever the things are supposed to take place, we should be prepared for that situation, right? These all things I am going to cover in the unit 1, that is protective schemes. Now if I talk about in unit 2, unit 2 is basically, it will deal only with the electromagnetic relays. Inside that we have operating systems, we have operating principles of relays. There we have universal relay, torque equation we are going to discuss. Let me just write over here. So in that we are going to discuss electromechanical relay, sorry, not electromechanical, but it is electromagnetic. Both relays are very different from each other. So we are going to discuss electromagnetic relay. I think till now you must be aware that what is the function of relay. As relay is one kind of equipment that will actuate the circuit breaker, that will give command to my circuit breaker whether to trip or not, right? So that is also important. And in unit 3 we are going to discuss apparatus protection. That is very important. In unit 3 we are going to discuss apparatus protection. Okay, so after discussing these three units, the main unit will begin from unit 4, and over there we are going to study about the static and numerical relays, where we will be having calculation based on the different equations. We will be having how to calculate the fault current. We would be calculating the actuating time of relay. Yes. And then we have the current transformer and potential transformer, CT and PT. I think the abbreviations you must be aware. And then after we will discuss how we can give over current protection, how we can give over voltage protection, what all different type of protection schemes that already we have learned, we will be learning in unit 3. So in unit 4 simply we are going to apply our learnings, right? In unit 4, let me write the heading that we are going to discuss about the static relays and we are going to discuss about the numerical protection. Yeah. Alright, then the unit 4, and this I can say that this could be a last module of your subject, circuit breakers, very important. Not only circuit breaker we are going to discuss, but along with that we are going to discuss the types of isolators are used, the types of circuit breakers are used, its cost, its maintenance, how we can increase the efficiency of circuit breaker, right? How circuit breaker performs, how it isolates the faulty part from the healthy part. So these all terminologies, you know, basic terminologies we are going to discuss in detail, step by step. So students, let me tell you that this video sessions I have made for just creating awareness that yes, in this session from now onwards we are going to launch switchgear and protection series, wherein we would be considering your queries, we would be considering the numericals which are based on this particular subject. And yes, it will help you in your examination, I could say. It will help you to understand this chapter in detail, and also after completing your diploma or even in your degree, you can pursue your master's in this particular subject. So believe me, this is going to be a very useful session for all of you, those who are in diploma engineering or those who are in degree engineering. So students, by this much only, I would like to take a leave from all of you. So yes, goodbye everyone, take care.